Hi friends, we'll solve problem on D'Alembert's principle. What is given? A block of weight 200 Newton is being pulled up the plane with velocity 2 meter per second. When for a short time, force in cable varies according to the equation F equal to 20 T square plus 134.64 Newton, where T is time in second. Find the velocity of the block 2 seconds after the variable force is applied. Now here what force is acting is a variable force. That means as T varies, force varies. Whenever force acting on body is constant, then body is subjected to constant acceleration. But as force is variable, acceleration of block is not constant. That means you have to use some variable acceleration concept. That means equations of motion, that is v equal to u plus at, v square equal to u square plus 2as, and s equal to ut plus half at square, these equations are not valid because acceleration of block is not constant, because force acting is not constant. That means force is variable force, acceleration is also variable acceleration. Now if we'll draw free body diagram of this block, initially conditions are what? Initial velocity is 2 meter per second. Then you have to find out velocity of block 2 seconds after the variable force is applied. First we will draw free body diagram of this block. Let's see in FBD what we will get. FBD of block. Now block is in motion, and that is on inclined plane. Therefore, say this one is a block which is in motion. Now this is subjected to variable force as well as weight action downward direction. Weight of this block is given as a 200 Newton. Angle is what? 30 degree. As inclination of plane is 30 degree, that means now if we'll represent what? Say component of weight, the one component will get perpendicular to plane. Here what will get is nothing but normal reaction, that is Rn. Another component of weight in this direction, here one force F is acting, right? Now this angle is same as that of inclination of plane, because plane is inclined at 30 degree. If we'll resolve this 200, we'll get this component 200 cos of 30, which comes out to be 173.20 Newton, and 200 sin 30 means this component, what we'll get here is what? 100 Newton. Due to force F, this block accelerates along the plane in upward direction. Therefore, frictional force what we'll get is in downward direction. Mu is 0.2 given. Therefore, frictional force is what? 0.2 Rn. As perpendicular to plane, there are only two forces. Therefore, this Rn is definitely equal to 173.20 Newton. If we'll multiply here by 0.2, we'll get frictional force. And if we'll calculate, comes out to be 34.64 Newton. Due to force F, important force what is acting now, which one is, we are not represented it, is what? Inertia force. Therefore, you must know direction of acceleration, that is nothing but A along the plane in upward direction. Now, inertia force is what? Mass into acceleration. Be careful here, inertia force is not 200 into A, because 200 Newton is not mass. That means, as weight is given, you have to find out what? Mass. How will you get mass? W equal to mg, that means m is w upon g, that means 200 upon g, 200 upon 9.81 comes out to be 20.38 into what? A. Now this one is a complete free body diagram. Now if we'll apply here equation along the plane, assuming in upward direction, say forces are positive, say this positive x-axis. Summation of Fx equal to 0, assuming forces along the plane in upward direction positive. Now what will you get? That force F, this is positive. Next one, component of weight is 100, this is negative. Frictional force is also negative, 34.64. Any other force, so that is inertia force, minus 20.38 A equal to what? 0. Now, if we'll substitute your value of f, which is given as what? 20 t square plus 134.64. This is the value of f. This one is minus 134.64 and is equal to what? 20.38a. Now, this 134.64, what you are getting positive, this one is negative, gets cancelled. That means now what you will get? Can you write this equation as what? From this one, a equal to 20 t cube divided by 20 t square. This one force what is given is 20 t square. That means a equal to now 20 divided by 20.38. That means this one comes out to 0.981 t square, because constant term gets cancelled. 134.64 get cancelled. That means this one, now what we are getting? Simple problem of variable acceleration type. Now a is a function of time t, therefore this a, if we'll write as a dv by dt in terms of time t, we'll get 0.981 t square. That means dv equal to 0.981 t square dt. If we'll integrate this equation, integral of dv equal to integral of 0.981 t square dt. Now initial velocity is given. Given t equal to 0, this velocity is given as 2 meter per second. At 2 second, I will write velocity as v2. That means velocity at 2 second. If we integrate it, this one becomes v. That means what will get here? Upper limit v2 minus lower limit is what? 2 equal to 0.981. It becomes t cube by 3. That means what? 1 by 3, t cube means 2 cube minus 0. That means unknown term is what? Directly we will get what? Velocity of particle. That is nothing but what? V2 comes out to be 4.616 meters per second. This one is velocity of this block after 2 seconds. Thank you.